Hello everyone, this is Noble H. Mushtaq, and today we are going to review the scores from Meet Number 1, Maine Association of Math Leagues, 2015 to 2016. So the Maine Association of Math Leagues is a math competition, and Meet Number 1 was on October 7th, 2015. So that's about 3 or 4 weeks before this video was made. And I'm just going to go through and see how people did with the scores. So first, here are the different math leagues. Central Maine, Down East Maine, Eastern Maine, Pinecone North, and Pinecone South. Okay, so all of these students are from one of those math leagues, and they're also from very different schools. So, and it's all across Maine. And we also have a little historical context for this, which is the state meet. So the state meet from last year is a meet that a lot of people from this year competed in, because people compete in these math leagues throughout their high school career. So we're going to compare these scores to the scores that people that we're reviewing on the meet number one got. So we're going to compare the state meet scores to the scores they got on this meet. Okay, so first let's go down through this list. As you can see, they listed the top 50 people here. So 50th, there's a bunch of people tied for 50th place, and they all got 47. And then we go all the way up, and we get to 60. 60 is a perfect score. So if you get a 60, that means you got a perfect score. Here, 5 people got a perfect score. Me, Noble Mushtaq, my brother, Simon Mushtaq, Loda Zhang from Don Baps, Elliot Youth from Scoreball, and Connor Thompson from Bingoy. And as you can see, a lot more people got 55. If you got 55, that means you got one problem wrong, but it was one of the hardest problems. So the hardest problems are 5 points, so that means they got one 5-point problem wrong. So as you can see, a lot of people tied for 6th place and got a 55. So let's see who these people are in terms of last year's state meet. So, let's start with Connor Thompson and Elliot Youth. Last year, Connor Thompson and Elliot Youth were juniors that got perfect scores on the state meet. So they got perfect scores on this meet, and they got perfect scores on the state meet. Getting a perfect score on the state meet is actually really hard, and this was probably easier than that. Loda Zhang. Loda Zhang was 3rd in sophomores, but overall she was 40th. So in the state meet, there's 6 rounds, and so that means there's 1 round is 12 points, so that means there's a total of 72 points. This person got a 54 out of 72, which means they were 40th place. They didn't tie with anyone, but they were 3rd for sophomores. So if you go down here, they were 3rd for sophomores. And if you go back here, so the other two people are me and my brother, Noble Mushtaq and Sammy Mushtaq. So let's see. Sammy Mushtaq he tied for 18th in the state meet, got 58 out of 72, and I tied for 31st, so just 55 out of 72. If you look at how Sammy did, Sammy was a sophomore last year, and he got 2nd for sophomore, and if I see how I did, I was an 8th grader last year, and I got 1st out of the 8th graders. But if you compare me to the freshmen, because there's not many 8th graders, so comparing me to 8th graders isn't really that useful, I tied for 2nd with freshmen, because I tied with this person who also got a 55. So, and we'll also see some, we can also look at some people that did good at the state meet, but didn't, what the scores were on this meet. So, if we go down the list. Okay, so all the seniors graduated, so obviously they're not going to be here. So we'll start with the juniors. Elliot Youth and Connor Thompson were 1st. What did Isaac Robinson get? Isaac Robinson. Oh, that's weird. He's not on this list. Okay, so apparently Isaac Robinson isn't on this list. That's weird. Let's see. Okay, so he's from Bangor, so that means he's in Eastern Maine. So Isaac. Okay, so Isaac Robinson got 46, which means that he didn't make the top 50, which is why he's not on this list. But he also did very good. because 46 is very good. As you can see, 50th place got 47. So he was 1 point behind, so that's also very good. And on the state meet, he got 69, which means he only got one problem wrong. It was a very easy problem, but only one problem wrong. Because that means you lost 3 points, which means you got 1 3-pointer wrong. And 3 points are the easiest problems. And let's see. And now we can go to sophomores. Okay. So the top sophomore is Peter Nielsen. Let's see how he did. Peter Nielsen got a 51, which is also very good. Very good. 51. So that means he probably got two, maybe three 3-pointers wrong, but probably two problems wrong. Maybe a 4-pointer or 5-pointer. We can actually look at the specifics later. But, and then Simon Muschek, Lotus Zane got first. Okay, let's go down to the freshman. Brett Foster. Brett Foster got a 67 on the state meet, which means he only missed one problem at the state meet. One 5-pointer. And here again, he got 55, so he only missed one 5-pointer at this meet. So, let's see. And we also, and we looked, did we look at Young? We didn't. So, Yawen Liu. What school is she from? Thornton. Okay, so she's in PyCon South. So. 1 second. Thornton. Ah, okay, so she got a 33 at this meet. And at the state meet, she got a 55. Okay. Not bad. Not bad. I don't think any of these people did bad. I don't know. I think if you get a 30, that's good, because I don't know. I just don't think any of these people did bad. It's just that they did worse than they did before. Well, not all of them. Anyway, it's confusing. Also, just because you do bad at one meet doesn't mean that you're going to do bad overall, because you can make it up later. So if she gets, like, a 60 on these four meets, then she'll probably be, like, first or something. Because that's really good, if you get, like, a 60 on, like, four meets. And who else should we look at? How about we look at the other 8th graders? So, these are all 8th graders that went to Maine Association Math League last year, even though it's a high school competition. So I was one of the 8th graders. And Jordan Ferialt. Okay. What school is he from? Caribou. I don't know where that is. Is he on this list? No, he's not. Okay. I'm just going to look for the name Jordan Ferialt. No, I don't, he's not on this list. He's not on this list. He's not on this list. No. Okay, he's not on this list. And if you look at all of the people from PyCon South. Okay, he's not, also not. So, he probably didn't compete. And Ian Form is from South Portland. So South Portland, I know, is in PyCon South. No. So Ian. Wait, no, actually, it probably Form. So there's someone named Andrew Form from South Portland. There's no one named Ian Form from South Portland in this meet. That's very odd. Very odd. Okay, then. That's interesting. So most of the 8th graders didn't come back, I guess? Actually, we can look at more 8th graders. Ryan Worcester and William. Let's just look for Worcester, because there's two people with the last name Worcester. Worcester, no. Worcester? Worcester. Oh, Worcester Jason. Okay, so this person came back. But the other, but Guy in Worcester did not come back. Also, they're from different schools, even though they have the same last name. Okay, so maybe they're not related. Okay, so if they're from different schools, like, I should check all of them. Worcester. Okay. Wait, no. Oh, Ryan Worcester. Oh, Ryan Worcester did come back. He got an 18 on this meet. That's pretty good. And how much did Jason Worcester get? Jason Worcester got a 13 on this meet, which is also pretty good. Yeah. And they got a 17 and 11 on the state meet, respectively, out of 72. So. Yeah, that's interesting. So, yeah. I'm just gonna. Yeah. Okay. So now, let's actually look at individual school scores. So now we looked at individual scores, now we can look at school scores. So these, actually, scores. All schools. Okay. Okay, so these are all the schools from each of the leagues, as I've put up here. Oh, you know. Okay, those are the schools from PyCon North. So as you can see, these are all the schools. And if you want to see all the schools from the state, you can go here. So, first is Bangor Red. Second is MSSM Ivory. So, MSSM is the main school of math and science. They're going to come up a lot because they're really good. Because they're school of math and science. So, they have, like, multiple teams, like Ivory and Emerald, and I don't know. I don't keep track. So, yeah, they're really good. So, they're second. Bangor also has multiple teams, I think. They name their teams with colors. So, Bangor Red, Bangor Platinum, Bangor Gold, Bangor Honor and Hutto, Bangor White, oh wow, Bangor Silver, Bangor Black. So, they have six teams. MSSM has Ivory, Emerald, Crimson, Mauve. So, MSSM has four teams. John Babst, okay, so, see, this is confusing. John Babst Purple, John Babst Silver, John Babst White. So, John Babst has three teams. And John Babst got third, Freiburg, Gold, Silver, Platinum, so they have three teams, Thornton Academy. So, I don't know how the color scheming works, but I do know how letters work. So, as you can see, some teams name their teams by color, like Red and Ivory, and that's confusing, so I don't understand that. But other teams, like Moshwood, which is the school I'm from, name their teams by letters. So, if we go here, Moshwood got is in 9th place and got a 290. So that's actually Moshwood A. And if you go down here, there's also Moshwood B, who's got a 30th. So Moshwood A is better than Moshwood B. And we also sometimes have a C team, which usually not. But Moshwood C would be worse than Moshwood B. And there's usually only like two people on the C team. Okay, so yeah. Those two people are really good, but since they're a team by themselves, they don't do really good. Because most teams have like 10 people. Anyway, so Thornton Academy is in 5th, and I think they have three teams, A, B, and C. So yeah, as you can see, the reason I just explained that to you, so B team is supposed to be better than C team, but Thornton Academy's C team beat Thornton Academy's B team, which is very, why did they do that on purpose? That's very confusing. So the C team beat the B team. I guess that's good. That's just very confusing because usually B team is supposed to beat C team. Anyway, I just found that interesting. Scorbo is in 6th. Scorbo has two teams, A and B, and the B team might not have 10 people. I'm just guessing by their score. They might not have 10 people. Actually, I think I can check. Yes. So this is Scorbo A. And so Scorbo B. Okay, so they have 7 people on the B team. So this is all of the people on the B team. So that's not a full team. And they still have 98. So that's pretty good. Chevris. Chevris has 3 teams. Chevris A got a 7th place. Chevris B got 47th place. And Chevris C got 109th place. 69. Okay. Greeley tied with Chevris. Greeley only has one team. Okay. So Greeley got 293, just like Chevris did. And Moshwood is the team I'm from. Got 9th place. And they also have B team, which got 30th place, and tied with Thornton Academy's B team. And lastly, we have MSSM again. So as you can see, MSSM has two teams in the top 10. MSSM Ivory and MSSM Emerald. So, that's just, yeah. Also, if we go back to the state meet. Yes. So, if we go back to the state meet. Okay. There's MSSM, and there's MSSM Extra. So, they bought two teams to the state meet. So, MSSM has a lot of, they're just really good. So is Bingo and other schools. But MSSM is just, you'll see them a lot through this competition. So yeah. So these are our top 10. And then out of 133 schools. So yeah. And there's one more thing that we can check. The other thing that we can check is what people usually got long. So, okay, so on some websites, they'll show you exactly what this, how many points people got in each round. So, each round is from a different category, which I'll show you here. This is meet one, so these are all the different categories we have to do, and then the sixth round is team round, so they don't count the sixth round in the individual scores, it's only counting the school scores. So they have to do five rounds, and then some, yes, so like here, they show you how each person did in each round. So this is a lot of numbers to go through, so instead I'm just going to go through the top scores that are like above 47, since 47 was the top 50. So in this, I think that there was only one person that got above 47, which was the 50 person got 55, Zhu Bohan, and they got one problem wrong in round two. Round two was inequalities and absolute values. Okay, so inequalities and absolute values is a pretty hard round in my opinion. I don't think I'm allowed to tell you the specifics of what the problem was, but I do remember that problem, and I think that was the hardest problem on the meet, in my opinion. That's just my opinion. So he got that problem wrong. This central main does not show you the scores from each round, so you can't really see that. I don't think... No, so Eastern Main also doesn't do that. They don't break the scores down by scores, by rounds. And... Oh. And PyCon North also doesn't do that, so you can't look at PyCon North. So what we can look at is PyCon South, because PyCon South has a website and not a PDF, which makes... Oh, that's weird. This website doesn't work sometimes. Anyway, so it makes it a lot easier, because you can just, like... You don't get all of the information at once, so you can have a lot more information. So if you look at the people that got 55, let's see what problems they got wrong. They got... One person got round 3... wrong, the hardest problem around 3, which is matrices, determinants, and systems equations. I don't quite remember that problem, but just in general, matrices is usually hard, just in general. So, this one's got number 2 wrong, so he got the inequality problem wrong. I almost got that wrong, but yeah, I thought that was a hard problem. This person also got round 2, number 5 wrong. And this person also got round 2, number 5 wrong. So as we can see, round 2, number 5 was a harder problem. And that probably separated people between... if we go back here. We have a bunch of people that got 55. And we have then we have 5 people that got a perfect score. So that might have been the separator in many cases. Just that one inequality problem. I thought that was a whole problem. If you look at this person got a 52, and they got a 7 in round 2, which means that they got the number 5 problem in round 2 wrong, which is the inequality problem. So they also got the inequality problem wrong. And then I'll just look at everyone above 50, since there's a lot of people here. This person got a 7 in round 2, which means they also got the inequality problem wrong, and then round 3, they got the number 4 problem wrong. Again, round 3 is matrices. So... He got a matrix problem wrong, and he got the inequalities problem wrong. This person got... Okay, he got a perfect round in everything except round 2. So that means he got a 3 in round 2, which means that he got the 4th problem wrong, and the 5th, the 4-point problem wrong, and the 5-point problem wrong. So he also got that problem wrong. Oh, this person got a perfect score in round 2, which is really good. So he got that problem, but he did not get the round 5... 5-point problem. Oh, geometric similarities. So that was a geometry problem, which might have been... Let's see, what grade is this? So he's in 10th grade. In America, 10th grade is usually when you learn geometry. So it was an easy problem, but you needed to learn specific geometry theorems. So this person might not have known that geometry theorem yet. So that's understandable. And he also got a number 4... Oh, arithmetic with star operations. In my opinion, that's kind of the easiest. But again, people make mistakes. Round 5, number 5, I think was easy, but you needed to know a specific theorem. And if you did not know that specific theorem, then it was very hard. This person got a 7 in round 2, which means he also got that inequality problem wrong. And he got an 8 in round 3, which means he got one of the matrices problem wrong. This person also got a 7 in round 2, which means he got the inequalities problem wrong. And round 4 was number theory. Number theory is kind of hard. It can be hard sometimes. I do not remember the 0.4 problem or ground 4, which is what this person got wrong. But that's understandable. So if that he got that wrong. This person from my school. Hi, Mary. And this person also got the inequality problem wrong. And they got a number theory problem wrong in round 4. I don't remember any of the other problems, so I can't tell if that, I don't remember if this was a hard problem or not. It might have been. It probably was, since this person got it wrong. So, okay. And this person also got the inequality problem wrong, because he got a 79 too. And they also got the 5-point problem in round 1 wrong. So that I think the 5-point problem in round 1, usually, you need, there's no calculator and you need to do arithmetic, so that might have been arithmetic error that got that problem wrong. So yeah, those are the scores from Maine Association of Math Leaks. We'll be watching all of, I'm going to archive this webpage, and I'm going to, so that if this change, I can compare it. Once Me Too happens and the scores for Me Too go up, I'm going to compare this, the people that got 60s and 55s, and just in the top 50 in general, and I'm going to see how they did in Me Too. So I'm going to compare the scores like that, and I'm also going to archive this page, which is the schools, all the schools, and I'm going to see how the top 10 changes from Meet 1 to Meet 2. So that'll be in the next scores overview video, and I hope this video was fun. I know it's not math, but it's a different video, kind of video, and have fun doing math!